Hello children, welcome to online mathematics class. So as I told you earlier, today we are going to do the word problems on rounding off of the numbers, word problems. So to do that, first of all I want you to open your textbooks and look into the page number 19. So did you all open? Yes, word problems. The school canteen prepares lunch for 377 children. For how many children should they actually prepare, rounded to the nearest 10? So how many children they are preparing the food? 377 children they are preparing the food. So what are they asking? For how many children they need to prepare if this number is rounded to the nearest 10. So nearest 10, we have discussed in the last class, if we want to round it up to the nearest 10, what we have to do? We have to see the tens place and ones place numbers. First of all, write the lower limit and upper limit, 370 and 380. So this is the number, this number lies in between 370 to 380. So observe the next number, that is the number which is there in ones place. So what is our rule? The number 5 or above 5 should be rounded up to the upper limit, that is 380. So if the number is rounded by 10, the school has to prepare the food for 380 children. Next question. Pankaj was taking sweets for his friends at school. There are 58 children in his class. How many sweets should he take rounded to the nearest 10? What is he doing? Pankaj is taking sweets to his friends. So how many students are there in his class? 58 children are there. Round up it to the 10 they are asking. So 58 lies in between 50 and 60. After 5, 8 is there. 8 is bigger than 5. So we have to round it up to the upper limit, that is 60. Round figure for 58 is 60. Next, third question. 68 students of a craft class are to be given one black glaze paper each to make a crow. How many black glaze papers should be craft teacher order to the nearest 10? So we are not bothered with the lengthy question or what they are going to make with the craft paper. We are only bothered with our numbers. So what are the numbers given here? 68 is the number given and it has to be rounded up to the 10. So 68 lies in between 60 and 70. 8 is bigger than 5. So the round figure is 70. Now how many papers teacher has to order? Teacher has to order 70 papers. Fourth question. 1465, that is 1465 people were expected for a school function. How many chairs should be hired rounded to the nearest 100? So how many people were expected? 1465. And how many chairs should be ordered if the number is rounded to 100? So how do you round the number by 100? Yes, you round the number by 100 writing its 100th limit, that is 1400 to 1500. The number is in between 1400 to 1500, 1400 to 1500. After 4, what is there? Now we are rounding up to the 100. So we have to check the number which is there in tens place. So 6. 6 is above 5. So we have to round it up to the 1500, that is 1500. So the school management has to order 1500 chairs for their school function. Sorry. Now, next topic. As I told you earlier, we are going to learn Roman numerals. What is Roman numerals? Observe the board once. How did I write fourth class? I wrote it in a different number. I did not use the number 4 to write it. Why is it so? So that it conveys the, so I wrote it in the Roman numerals. What are Roman numerals? Roman numerals are also a number system where we use different symbols to write the numbers. For example, 1, 5, 10, L, C, D and M. 1 is 1, 5, 10, 50, 100, 500 and 1000. So, these symbols indicate these numbers. So, 1 means the value is 1 and the letter V means the value is 5. And X denotes 10, L denotes 50, C denotes 100, D denotes 500 and M denotes 1000. To write Roman numerals, we have few rules. The rules are, all of you turn the page number 20, after the word problems. And the one more most important thing is, zero number does not exist in Roman numerals. And for writing numerals, there are few rules. I will just read it out. You just observe in the textbook. Write numeral 1. The numeral 1 is used for 1, 2, 3. We cannot repeat numerals more than 3 times. So, what is telling? We cannot repeat this numeral more than 3 times. So, how do we write? We write 1, 2 and 3. Yes or no? We don't write 4 like this. Do we write like this? No. What do we write? We write it as 1 and V. So, what does this indicate? This indicates that if there is a number, bigger number, and if we write a smaller number on the left side, this is my left side, right? That means this indicates subtraction. That means this conveys 5 minus 1, okay? This is 5 symbol and 1 is written to the left hand side. That means we have to subtract 1 from the given number. So, 5 minus 1 is 4. So, that is the reason why we write 4 like that. And if a number is added on the right side of the bigger number, then what does it indicate? It indicates that we have to add the number, just like 6. What does this mean? This means 5 plus 1. This is 5 and this is 1. That is 5 plus 1. Even though we don't write plus symbol here, but this conveys that this is 5 plus 1. So, these are the rules for writing the Roman numbers. And there is one more rule. When a bigger number, only one x and 10, that is 1, 10 and 100 can be repeated. Only these numbers can be repeated. Other numbers cannot be repeated. For example, we cannot write like this or we cannot write like this. Only this number and this number can be repeated if you want to write any number in Roman numbers. Now, coming to the exercise 1.6, fill the empty boxes in the two tables. So, what he has given? He has given us a table. What table did he give us? He has given us a table. First is Hindu Arabic numbers, that is the regular numbers that we use. And the second column is Roman numbers. And the third column is what it exactly means. We have to expand. For example, take 8 here. What does it convey? 8. 8 conveys. Eight, one, two, three. So what does this mean? This means 5 + 1 + 1 + 1. So this thing you have to write in the third column, expansion of this Roman numbers. And in the second box, you have to write how we denote the numbers in Roman numbers and its expansion. Now, with this topic, we have completed our lesson, our chapter. Now let us do the chapter drill. Chapter drill is nothing but all the questions covering all the topics that we have learnt in this chapter. So, page number 22, chapter drill. Write the place values of colored digit in each of the following. This one you know already. We have solved so many problems in the exercise. Colored digit, you have to write its place value. First one, I will tell it orally. 85,479. 8 is there. 8 is in 10,000's place and it is highlighted in pink color. So, 8 is 10,000. That is, the place value is 10,000. So, remaining also you can do. Even 6 digits also you can do it very easily. Second one is very simple. Look at the abacus scale and write the number. Count the beads and write in the place values exactly, then you will get the number. The third question is expanded form of the number. That is also very easy. 92,368. That means 90,000 plus 2000 plus 300 plus 60 plus 8. That is the expanded form. And next, compare and put less than or greater than symbols. Very simple. You know how to compare the numbers. You compare the last digits and you move on to the right hand side if the digits are same. For example, take the example E, 65,432 and 65,232. Here 10,000's place and 1,000's place are same. So, you compare hundreds and write which number is bigger and which number is smaller. Next, question number 5, rounds. Oh, in this topic we have did word problems also. 238 rounds to nearest 10. What is nearest to 10? 240. 240 will be the nearest round to 238 for 10. 7449 rounds to nearest to 100. So, what does it mean? 7449 nearest to 100. That means 8 is between 8000 and 7000. So, 7449, 4 is less than 5. So, 7400 will be the nearest round up to that number. And 4678 round to the nearest 1000. What is the nearest 1000? Here 4600 is given. 6 is there. 6 is bigger than 5. So, you can round it to the 5000. And next one is, write the Roman numbers equal to the following Hindu Arabic number. 12, you have to write in Roman numbers. 15, you have to write in Roman numbers. In the same manner, other examples also. Worksheet, page number 23. This is also very interesting exercise. The jars show the rounded figure. Identify the correct number of toffees that can be put in the jar. Round it. So, there are 800 chocolates in one jar and there are 3 other numbers. So, you have to round it the nearest number. The jar's capacity is 800 and the numbers given are 820, 735 and 878. So, 820 is near to 800. 735 is very far to 800. If we put 735 number, the jar will be very empty. and 878. The jar's capacity is only 800, but we cannot put 878 now chocolates. So the suitable number is 820. In the same manner, you can do the other examples also. So with this exercise, we have completed our first chapter. With a new chapter, let us meet in our next class. Until then, thank you all.